Words are empty. Blah, blah, blah. I don't want to hear your excuses. I don't want to hear you to say, I'm so good person because I pray. Because I believe in God. Because I believe in Allah. Because I believe in God or something else. Believing in something does not make you a good person. Can we please step into reality? Good people don't say they're feel upset. Good people stand up against the oppressive scams who will profit from the suffering of others. Good people don't say they are against something. They actually show it. Good people, good, honest people, don't support a systematic oppression, torture, enslavement, murder, and kidnapping. A good, honest, civilized system will not support industries like the animal agriculture industry or the sex trade. No, my friend. A good, honest, civilized society will protect all innocent living beings, no matter how weak or oppressed they are. Animals are not inanimate objects. Until you are laws, your laws. Stop blaming and playing retarded by claiming that animals are inanimate objects. I think fuck the law. Fuck the law and screw them, break them, humiliate them, turn them upside down and put them in the creek. Or put them in the cliquo or put them in the trash bag. Don't come up with the insane, stupid law argument, the law fallacy. Slavery was law in South Africa. In the time of South Africa apartheid, you cannot legally be considered a rapist when you rape black woman. In the time of slavery, if you sadomistically humiliate blacks by taking away their masculinity by putting them objects with sometimes a hand, sometimes a stick in the anus of a nigger, then it was not considered a criminal offense because blacks were property in that time. When you look at Saudi Arabia, you can legally marry children, you can legally abuse your wife, and more of that's idiocracy. So let me not go to that insanity that laws equal to justice. Law is a symbol of might, make right, power, and nothing more, nothing less. And if somebody have great arguments why a law should be considered a fable instead of justice and should be replaced, then on that moment I think that law should be dismantled. And lawyers have to stop, and judges have to stop worshipping on the altar of the book. And start to realizing that their book maybe is not so great as they think. Maybe the laws are outdated. Maybe the laws are hypocritical and do not make real sense. There's maybe time that they look to themselves instead of blaming anybody else. like a bunch of whiners. And I'm also aware. Check out the Cambridge Declaration of Consciousness. Where what a fish knows. Where other great legislation on the fact that animals are sentient and aware to the degree that we claim to be. If you ask me, many animals are far more aware as us, but scientists have actually say that that animals are aware to the same degree that we are. But since the majority of people will drown if there come a tsunami in their village, and most animals escape long before that's coming, I think animals are far more aware of their environment as we are. The Homo megalomania. Or Homo stultus. Homo ridiculus. Superbia, maybe. So, have I to put more examples of why appealing to the law is a fallacy? If you want to know if something is right or wrong. Or must I go on and on about it? I can think make a video about from 2 hours about examples of why appealing to the law is a ridiculous fallacy. Maybe that is interesting to do. Tell me in the comments if you want that. And I will research a couple of days non-stop and find maybe over 100 examples of psychotic laws how protect victimizers and rapists and murderers in different countries around the world to prove why law is a stupid argument for moral morality. For now, listen good. If you are not a victim, don't imagine it entirely from your point of view. Because if you are not a victim, it becomes pretty easy to mock your victims, label them stupid and dirty, say that their life don't matter at all, like Himmler, like Gaddafi, like Stalin. And many more have done to their specific victims. But when you are the victim or speak up for the victims, things look a lot different from that angle. I don't want to hear your excuses. I want that you say that you have made a mistake and that you have the courage to admit that and make a plea and change. Stop being a cowardly, selfish prick. I was too afraid to admit when he is wrong. Make a plea and move forwards.